Welcome to my new video. You asked me to make a guide about the Russian lineup at the BR 4.7 and have a closer look at the heavy tank KV-1 Sys-5. Here we go. First, I want to talk about the BR 4.7 in realistic tank battles. The T-34-57 and the Isu-152 are at that BR. The KV-1 Sys-5 at the BR 4.3. I would recommend to skip the BR 4.7 and create a good lineup at the BR 4.3 for realistic battles. Don't punish yourself and just avoid the matches at 5.7. So you only will face the Panda D and the Tiger H1 and can avoid the Panda A and Tiger E. Because the gun of the KV-1 Sys-5 is good, but your enemies have better guns. I also had the feeling that I got only a few up-tier matches with Russia 4.3 and had way more down-tier matches. For my lineup, I used the T-34E STZ and the RSU-57 as backup tanks. But when you play the KV-1 Sys-5 in the right way, you don't need any backup tanks. Here are my tips. Avoid close combat at any cost. You have some armor, but your turret rotation speed is too slow. Fast enemy tanks can surround you and shoot on your weak side armor. And despite your outer armor, you still have some weak spots at the flat surface on your turret and your angled side. Even in a full down tier match, I recommend to stay further away at about 400 to 600 meters, and in up tier matches even further. Because the further away you are, the smaller your weak spots become and your slow turret rotation speed also becomes less of a disadvantage. Tip number 2. Play as support or sniper. Even in a full down tier match, don't brawl. The KV-1 Sys-5 is too slow compared to the enemies. Play from the second row or flank. You have a really good rifle scope and can hit enemies from 800 meters away easily. And with the better ammunition, the BR-350B, you get some more penetration value. Tip number 3. Angle your tank and peek and boom. Angle the KV-1 Sys-5 like the Tiger H1 to reduce the flat surfaces. Your turret, however, still has some weak spots and therefore wobble it or just turn it away while reloading and when your enemy fires. And again, the distance you keep is a huge advantage. Since you can't go hull down because of your bad gun depression, you want to peek and boom. I also experienced that in a full down tier match I was able to go to a position in the open field, angle my tank to the threat at that specific moment and bounce the shots, because I was further away and the enemy had a hard time to aim at my weak spots. I had some great matches considering these tips and the KV-1 Sys-5 even became one of my favorite tanks. The disadvantage is that you can't set the pace of the match, especially in a full down tier match. But you can draw the attention on you, bounce some shots and enable your team to capture the points. I hope I was able to give you some tips and you liked the video. Like, subscribe and leave some comments if you want to. Hope to see you in-game soon.